Hello friends, in the last video on FMEA, we had seen history, introduction and need of FMEA. This video is a continuation of last video explaining detailed procedure to conduct FMEA exercise with example. So let's begin to learn use of this extremely important tool in steps. Step 1. Preparation for FMEA. Basically, there are 3 sub-steps to confirm that we are ready to conduct FMEA exercise. Sub-step 1. Collect and create key documents. FMEA works smoothly through the development phases when an investigation of past failures and preparatory documents is performed from its arrival. Preparatory documents may include root cause analysis of past failures, block diagram and parameter diagram for design FMEA, process flow diagram and characteristics matrix for process FMEA. Sub-step 2. Form and assemble a cross-functional team of people with diverse knowledge about the process, product or service and customer needs. Functions often included are design, manufacturing, quality, testing, reliability, maintenance, purchasing, sales, marketing and customer service. Sub-step 3. Identify the scope of FMEA. Is it for concept, system, design, process or service? What are the boundaries and how detailed we should be? Use flowcharts to identify the scope and to make sure every team member understand it in detail. From here on, we will use the word scope to mean the system, design, process or service that is subject to our FMEA. Once we completed all these steps, fill in the identifying information at the top of our FMEA form. Below picture shows a typical format. To understand it more clearly, let's complete all the steps along with one practical example. Let's say we need to conduct process FMEA for ATM machine. This form contains system, subsystem, component, core team, FMEA number, prepared by, FMEA date, revision date and respective page number. In addition to that, this also indicates whether it is a design FMEA or process FMEA. Step 2. Path 1 development, that is process function through severity ranking. Path 1 consists of inserting the functions, failure modes, effects of failure and severity rankings. The pre-work documents assist in this task by taking information previously captured to populate the first few columns of the FMEA. Functions should be written in verb-noun context. Each function must have an associate measurable. Functions may include wants, needs and desires translated, specifications of a design, government regulations, program-specific requirements, characteristics of a product to be analyzed and desired process outputs. Failure modes are written as anti-functions or anti-requirements in 5 potential ways: full function failure, partial or degraded function failure, intermittent function failure, over function failure, and unintended function failure. Effects are the results of failure, where each individual effect is given a severity ranking. Actions are considered at this stage if the severity is 9 or 10. Recommended actions considered for effects that impact the product or process design addressing failure modes on high severity rankings for safety and regulatory. Let's see execution of step 2 in case of our example of ATM machine. Let's see the first column. It talks about process step or function. For an example of ATM machine, it will be dispense amount of cash requested by customer. The next column, that is potential failure mode, is about what can happen so that we will not be able to meet process function either partially or fully. Here, there can be multiple failure modes like does not dispense cash, dispense less cash or takes too long to dispense cash. For understanding purpose, let's talk about only one failure mode. Let's consider the failure mode of does not dispense cash for further steps. The column after potential failure mode, that is potential effect of failure, will explain what will be the result if failure happened. In case of our example, it would be customer very dissatisfied. To quantify severity of an effect, we are giving severity number to each effect on the scale of 1 to 10. 1 indicates no effect on safety and regulations, whereas 10 indicates very high effect on safety and regulations. By looking at the scenario, we can say it is a very high impact on customer satisfaction and scored as 8 And the last column in this step is classification of special characteristics, if indicated. These characteristics can be critical characteristics, which is a product feature or dimension that reasonably anticipated variation could directly affect compliance with government regulations or safe operation of the equipment. And other can be special characteristics, which is a feature dimension that reasonably anticipated variation could affect principal fit, function, durability, customer satisfaction, or manufacturability. Step 3, Part 2 Development, that is potential causes and preventive controls through occurrence ranking. Causes are selected from the design or process inputs or past failures and placed in the cause column when applicable to a specific failure mode. Let's see each of these columns with an example of ATM machine. The first column in Part 2 is potential causes or mechanisms of failure. In this column, we are listing all potential causes of an effect of customer very dissatisfied. These causes will be out of cash, machine jam, and power failure during transaction. And the second column is occurrence ranking for each cause. In this column, we will be quantifying probability of failure on the scale of 1 to 10. 1 indicates failure is unlikely and 10 indicates very high failure rate, that is, failure is almost inevitable. For these causes, we can score 6, 4, and 2, indicating moderate, moderate, and low probability of failures respectively. Step 4, Part 3 Development, that is, testing and detection controls through detection ranking. Path 3 development involves the addition of detection controls to verify that design meets requirements for design FMEA or cause and failure mode if undetected may reach to the customer for process FMEA. The columns completed in Path 3 are detection controls or current controls. For each cause, identify current process controls. These are tests, procedures or mechanisms that you know have been placed to keep failures from reaching the customer. These controls might prevent the cause from happening, reduce the likelihood that it will happen, or detect failure after the cause has already happened but before the customer is affected. In case of our example, these are internal low cash alert, internal machine jam alert, and no control respectively for causes mentioned in the Part 2. And detection ranking. For each control, determine the detection rating. This rating estimates how well the controls can detect either the cause or its failure mode after they have happened but before the customer is affected. Detection is usually rated on a scale from 1 to 10, where 1 means the control is absolutely certain to detect the problem and 10 means the control is certain not to detect the problem or no control exists. On the FMEA table, list the detection rating for each cause. In case of our example, we can score 5, 9 and 10 respectively for the current controls in Part 3. Step 5, Action Priority and Assignments. Calculate the risk priority number or RPN which equals S into O into D. For an example we had considered, it would be 240, 288 and 160 respectively for each of the potential causes. Also, calculate criticality by multiplying severity by occurrence, that is S into O. These numbers provide guidance for ranking potential failures in the order they should be addressed. In case of our example, it would be 48, 32, and 16 respectively. Identify recommended actions based on the priority score. These actions may be design or process changes to lower severity or occurrence. They may be additional controls to improve detection. Also note who is responsible for the actions and target completion dates. For example, in our case, these actions can be develop tracking system to ensure cash is available at all the time, plan and execute regular preventive maintenance of the machine, and to study and implement feasibility for installation of UPS respectively. Many organizations use an RPN threshold to determine which failure mode requires corrective action and which risks are acceptable. The RPM threshold is easy to use. However, using an RPM threshold may cause team members to spend excessive time trying to reduce the detection, occurrence, and severity rankings for lowering the RPM. This situation sometimes places the organization and its customer in danger. We can use following risk matrix which includes a combination of severity and occurrence. In this matrix, color indicators are red, the team must eliminate the risk or reduce its level. Yellow, the team should eliminate the risk or reduce its level. And green, acceptable risk. The other organizations may address the corrective action for the top RPMs. After that, the team reset and find another top RPMs for the next improvement process. This method promotes continuous improvement. Step 6. Actions taken or design review. FMEA actions are closed when countermeasures have been taken and are successful at reducing risk. The purpose of FMEA is to discover and mitigate risk. FMEA which do not find the risk are considered to be weak and non-value added. Effort of the team did not produce improvement and therefore time was wasted in the analysis. In this column, we have to mention actions taken. Like in our example, it could be implemented tracking system for cash available to avoid reoccurrence, etc., etc. And the last step is step 7, re-ranking RPM and closure. After successful confirmation of risk mitigation actions, the core team will re-rank the appropriate ranking value for severity, occurrence and detection. The new ranking will be multiplied to attain the new RPM. The original RPM is compared to the revised RPM and the relative improvement to the design or process has been confirmed. Columns completed in step 7 are re-ranked severity, re-ranked occurrence, re-ranked detection, re-ranked RPM, generate new actions, repeating step 5 until risk has been mitigated, and comparison of initial RPM and revised RPM. Let's go back to our example. After taking actions, our initial RPM had reduced from 240 and 288 to 32 and 48 respectively, indicating relative improvement. This is all about detailed illustration of FMEA along with practical example. I am sure you must like it. For references, in addition to my knowledge and experience, I have taken some part of it from ASQ website and Quality One website. You can use it these sites and can see more useful information in addition to FMEA. Now to end, please like and share this video if you have found it useful. To learn and Six Sigma in such an interesting way, please do not forget to subscribe my channel. And finally, thank you for watching.